ladies and gentlemen, I'm TWK of TWK Reviews, and I'm here to entertain you, and welcome to my top 5 favorite Undertaker matches. And obviously I'm doing this video because very recently, The Undertaker retired. Or so he seems to have been. It just seems really, really probable this time because he left all his gear in the ring. So, yeah, really sad. The Undertaker seems to have retired. It makes me sad. You're all probably sad as well. So let's celebrate The Undertaker with my top 5 favorite Undertaker matches. And let's just note one thing before we get started, officially, let's just make it known, my list, mine, not yours. So don't get offended if your favorite match does not show up here. In fact, I guarantee you guys are going to hate at least one of the matches that I bring up. So let's get started, shall we? At number 5, we have Undertaker versus The Undertaker. Yeah, this match is just nostalgic for me, mainly because the first time I watched this match was like back in 2005. My dad won a radio contest, and part of it was a DVD called The Undertaker, He Buries Them Alive, which is just a rip of the VHS that WWE made. Just cleaned up the video and audio, and it had some matches on there. And the first one on there was Undertaker versus Undertaker. Now, I wasn't aware that was the main event of SummerSlam that year. I just watched it, and I was like, oh, Undertaker versus Undertaker. That's a cool match, I guess. And obviously, it's not the best match in the world, but like I said, it's just nostalgic for me. So, there you go. It's for many, many years, it was the only time I got to see the old school Undertaker, you know, with the purple gloves, the hat, and the suit and all that. Because remember, this is back in 2005. This is before YouTube took off. This is before they really started their on-demand service. So this is definitely before the network. So for a long time, this is my only way of seeing the old school Undertaker. Number 4 versus Kane at WrestleMania 20. All right, for this match, what makes it special is, for a lot of people, this was the first time they got to see the old-school Undertaker. I mean, yeah, we had to play some of the video games, and maybe you picked up some old VHS tapes, or maybe they put some of his old matches on DVDs, but for a lot of people, including myself, this was our first time truly experiencing the old-school Undertaker, as for the past few years he had been the American Badass, you know? Coming out to either Kid Rock, Limp Bizkit, or "You've done it now, you've gone made a big mistake." You know, that type of music. And he'd come out with a motorcycle and he'd be the American Badass. He'd just be a more human Undertaker. So for a lot of us, this is the first time we got to see the Undertaker as the dead man, the essentially a living zombie and just using all these supernatural powers. So it wasn't that great match overall. It was just kind of there, and it was just there to showcase, you know, old school Undertaker. So yeah, just another match that was just there for nostalgia. Number 3 versus Kane in an Inferno match. I know this is technically cheating because I picked the same opponent twice, but number 1, these matches are 6 years apart, and number 2, it's an Inferno match, man. I mean, look at that! Kane's arm is on fire! And that really is the main draw of the match, is just seeing Kane's arm catch on fire! That's basically it. Overall, aside from that, it's just kind of alright, but I can't help but go back and watch it every now and again, just because Kane's arm is on fire. Number 2 versus the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels at WrestleMania 26! What can I say about this match that has not been said a million times? It's one of the greatest matches of all time. It's the final match of Shawn Michaels' entire wrestling career. And when you have a match that's this good, I honestly do not blame him for not coming back. Because when you leave on that good of a note, what more could you want to? You're like, why would I ever want to jeopardize that? And this match is, oh my god, if you have not seen it, what are you doing with your life? This match is so amazing. Go watch it. Seek it out. If not this, of all the matches on this list, this is one that is required watching if you're going to be a true hardcore wrestling fan, in my opinion. So go. After this video is done, of course, go watch it. It's amazing. It's awesome. It's one of the greatest wrestling matches that you'll ever see in your entire life. And that's not an exaggeration. Number 1 versus Brock Lesnar, Hell in a Cell. Yeah, this is my favorite Undertaker match. You might note that it's also the only match featuring the Undertaker in his American Badass gimmick. Now, the reason I love this match so much is because of how brutal it is. This is not a match for the faint of heart. There are people who can enjoy some pretty hardcore wrestling that still have problems watching this particular match because of, well, right there. Look at that blood. Just look at it. Look at it. It's amazing. I love it. Ah, so good. Sometimes you just gotta watch a good bloodbath in pro wrestling. It's really, really earned. I mean, of course, there was the storyline leading up, which was kind of meh. But overall, the feud Undertaker versus Brock Lesnar, it could only end like this. If only the WrestleMania 30 match could have been this good. But anyways, those are my top 5 favorite Undertaker matches of all time. What are your favorites? Let me know in the comments section down below. Also, be sure to follow me on all my social media platforms, which you can find down in the description. Also, if you are feeling super duper generous, I do have a Patreon, also located in the description down below. Be sure to donate if you so please. And if you donate $1 or more, you get to see videos like this before anyone else, and before I go slap happy with all the advertisements. Also, if you donate $5 or more, get your name here at the end credits. Also, if you donate $25 or more, you get your name at the beginning. Also, you get the ability to request a review for me to do. So, if you have a particular thing that you want me to review, that'd be $25, please. Yes, I am a cheap bastard. Also, I put that up just to stop any people from just spamming requests and all that snazzy jazz. Anyways, that's going to do it for me tonight. I am very happy to be finally doing a wrestling review, so that way this belt isn't just sitting up here on this couch for no reason. It actually has some relevance now, at least to some degree. Might need to do a WCW review in the future. But until next time, this is TWKF TWK Reviews. Telling you to work your gimmick, and yeah. I think that's it. I think I've covered everything. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. Before we get to the end card with all the clickable things on the video, let's get a preview of what my next review will be. Yes, SmackDown vs. Raw 2009 for the Nintendo Wii! I have not heard nearly enough people talk about this title, so I will!